which sets of ordered pairs represent valid functions. Recall each ordered pair is in the form of x, y, or the input, the output. And for review, recall that a function is a relation in which each input or x value has exactly one output or corresponding y value. Looking at the first set of ordered pairs, let's focus on the x values or inputs. The x values or inputs are negative 2, 2, 4, 7, and 16. Notice none of the inputs or x values are repeated more than once in the ordered pairs. And notice each has one corresponding output, which is the second value of the ordered pair, and therefore this first set of ordered pairs is a function. To emphasize this, let's go ahead and map the function. The domain would be the set of inputs, which in this case is negative 2, 2, 4, 7, and 16. The range is a set with elements negative 4, 3, 5, 8, and 15. The first ordered pair maps negative 2 to negative 4. The second ordered pair maps 2 to 3. The third ordered pair maps 4 to 5. The fourth ordered pair maps 7 to 8. And the fifth ordered pair maps 16 to 15. We can easily see each input has exactly one output, which is why we have a function. Looking at the next set of ordered pairs, again focusing on the inputs or x values, we have an x value of negative 1, the x value of positive 1 occurs twice, and then we have the x values of 9 and 10. Let's focus on the two ordered pairs that have the same input or x value of positive 1, these two ordered pairs. Notice these two ordered pairs indicate the input of positive 1 has two outputs, 2 and positive 4, because the input or x value of positive 1 has two corresponding outputs or y values, the set of ordered pairs is not a function because remember, in order to be a function, each input has exactly one output. So this set is not a function. Let's go ahead and map the relation to show it's not a function. The domain of the relation is negative 1, positive 1, 9, and 10. The range is negative 3, 2, 4, 7, and 14. The relation maps negative 1 to negative 3, 1 to 2, 1 to 4, 9 to 7, and 10 to 14. Notice the input of positive 1 has two corresponding outputs, which is why the set of ordered pairs is not a function. Looking at the next set of ordered pairs, looking at the x values, notice all the x values are the same, they're positive 5. The input of positive 5 has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different outputs. Because each input does not have exactly one output, the set of ordered pairs is not a function. Let's map this relation to emphasize it's not a function. The domain of the relation is positive 5, and the range is negative 4, negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, and 0. The input of positive 5 is mapped to each of the 5 outputs, which looks like this. And we can easily see the input of positive 5 has 5 outputs, not exactly one output, which again is why the third set is not a function. And for the last set of ordered pairs, again focusing on the x values, we have inputs of negative 4, negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, and 0. Because none of the inputs are listed more than once, we can see each input does have exactly one output. In this case, all the outputs are positive 5, but that doesn't change the fact that each input has exactly one output, and the set of ordered pairs does represent a function. Let's go ahead and map this function to emphasize the result. The domain is negative 4, negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, and 0. The range is only the element 5. Each of the inputs are mapped to positive 5, which looks like this. Notice each of the inputs does have exactly one output. It just happens to be the same output, but it doesn't change the fact that each input has exactly one output, and the set of ordered pairs does represent a valid function. I hope you found this helpful.